Hi everyone, my name is Rachel and welcome to The French Seams. Thanks very much for joining me again for another video. This is a Friday Sews video, so as always a huge thank you to Jen from Today in Jen's Sewing Room for setting up this fabulous hashtag. If you're new to my channel, then you're very, very welcome. And if you're a regular subscriber, you're very welcome back. And as always, a huge thank you to everybody who's watched any of my previous videos, anybody who's liked it, everybody who's left a comment. I really, really do appreciate it. So thank you very much. So I've got quite a bumper edition for you today. I've got a little make that I'm working on. I've got some plans. I've got a bit of a fabric haul and then my usual bits and bobs that I'd like to share with you. So, and that's the sun coming out from behind the clouds. Hooray. So I'll start with what I'm wearing. This is an oldie. So I made this in, I think, December 2020. And it is the Liesel & Co. Recital Blouse. And it's got a beautiful little frilly collar. You can tie up the buttons all the way to the top or leave it open. I think it's really pretty. It's a double gauze fabric with these little gold dots on it. And I did all the trimming in gold metallic thread. So you've heard me talk about this thread before. This is the Gutermann metallic thread. Oh, very shiny now. The Gutermann metallic thread that just breaks my heart every single time I use it. But I can't remember who I was watching recently and they said that they had bought specific metallic needles. So I really, really have to give that a go because that just breaks in my machine the whole time and it's very frustrating. So if I can get special metallic needles, which I did not know were a thing, I think using that thread might be much easier. So because I did all the buttonholes, I've done top stitching on other garments in it as well, so it's tricky. So the reason I'm wearing this today is, there's a couple of reasons. One is I'm taking part in this challenge called WAW October Challenge. And it's set up by What Abby Wore, who's new to me on Instagram. But I saw this challenge because the lovely Annie over on Instagram, she's a great channel, I'll link her channel below, mentioned this great challenge. And it's basically all these prompts for all of October. And it's a really, really good way of kind of getting your October wardrobe up and running and kind of thinking about what you're wearing. So it's a bit of a me made May in October, which suits me down to the ground. So the prompt was style a rarely worn item, and I wanted to style this because I just found it in my wardrobe the other day because I was doing my summer clothes clear out and I found this and I rarely wear it. I don't wear it because I don't think I like double gauze, and I think that's going to be a terribly unpopular opinion, and I do apologise if I upset anybody, but I'm not sure I like double gauze. But the fabric is beautiful, it's a lovely autumnal colour, I love the gold dots, I think it's really great. So I want to style that, and I've been styling it with my knee-high boots, my brown ones, which have been getting an awful lot of love on Instagram. I think everybody loves those boots, I do too, you'll be seeing an awful lot more of them. But I thought I'd give it a shot, and I am really enjoying it. But then the second reason I'm wearing it is because I led you astray last week in my planned video where I planned to make a new to me pattern company's blouse with a little ruffle collar. So I went on their website during the week to buy that pattern and I realized it's paper pattern only. You can't buy the PDF. So I'd have to buy the paper pattern, pay for that, pay for shipping, trace. No, I'm very sorry. No. So then I found this shirt and I was like, hang on a sec. This is a ruffle collar shirt. I have this pattern already. Let's just move this. So hopefully you don't mind the little little substitution that I'm doing to substitute away from that shirt and move this back in, because I think this is a really, really cute shirt. So I did make this for Christmas 2020 when I was 8 months pregnant. And what I did was, because it's a beautiful shirt, it's a princess seam shirt. So what I did was the princess seams here, I sewed them to here and then I insert two godets down the front. So I just made my regular size and just put in two godets, so two triangle pattern pieces all the way down. And it worked really, really well for Christmas 2020. And then afterwards, I took out the godets, sewed them back up and they became princess seams again. So it was quite cute actually the way it worked out. So to make a short story very, very long, that was really why I'm wearing this shirt today and why I wanted to share it with you. But yes, so you might see this is now in my plans and not the other shirt. So apologies, you know me and paper patterns, we just don't get on well together. So anyway, that's what I'm wearing today. What else have I been up to? So I have been doing a little bit of sewing. I made a few gifts for people, my little wine bottle covers, which I link below, also little gift pouches I've been doing. So I've had a few little gifts that I want to give people, so I've been making a few of those up. I also made this little pattern, which is the cutest thing. So apologies, I still have a bit of a cough. So I've been talking about So Carol's channel on here a few times. I just love her channel. I think she makes the most beautiful things. She does lovely kind of crafty things. I think she's really, really inspiring. Her channel is just gorgeous. So I'd encourage you, if you don't follow her already, to go over and look at her channel. But a little while ago, she put up a pattern for a tissue box holder, kind of a tissue holder instead of the little cardboard box. And I just thought it was such a cute idea. So I made that during the week. And here's my version. It's even the sun. So it's in Peppa Pig fabric, the Fat Quarter Aldi, thank you very much. It's got the little flap at the back, a little bit of binding, and then the little tissue. And it is the cutest little make, and I absolutely love it. So thank you, Carol, for that little tutorial. Such fun to make, and I'll link that below. Really, really cute pattern. So those are things I've been getting sewing this week. So little tiny projects, because I've been buying patterns, I've been pre-washing fabric, so I have a little bit of a lull in my regular sewing. So what I also did was I did a little bit of fabric shopping. So I'd alluded to that on my makes video, on my plans video, sorry, that I needed to do a bit of fabric shopping because my stash has run dry. So I took a little trip to the fabric counter in Dublin and I got some great little bits and bobs. So the first thing I got is, and that's going to be really white with the sun, is polar fleece. So lovely fleecy fabric, a gorgeous white colour. It's kind of textured on one side, not on the other, so I think I'll use the textured side as the right side. And this is going to be gorgeous for my half zip sweatshirt, the French navy pattern. I think this will look lovely in the white. I think that's really, really nice. The next thing I bought, because I just thought it was so beautiful, is this gorgeous webbing. Apologies now at the sun, hopefully you can see that color. So it's kind of brown and gold webbing. I think it's absolutely gorgeous. So I bought a little bit of that because I'm working on a bag pattern, which I'm hoping I can show you soon, but I won't go into any more details. So I'm going to make a little bag pattern, and I'm going to do the outer in Aldi Fat Quarter with leaves, lovely powder blue color. I'm going to do the lining in pink Disney Princesses, just because you can. And then I'm going to do the binding in this lovely it's called kind of an oatmeal-y colour with pumpkins. So I think those two blend really, really nicely together. So this is going to be a lovely little bag, which I'm hoping I can share with you very soon. To help with that, I also bought this, which I've been looking to buy for a long time. So it's a So Easy quilt and sew ruler. So, and this is, so it's 12 by about 6, I think, and that's going to come really, really handy. So I do have my French curve, but I use that sometimes to cut a straight line with a rotary cutter, and I've nicked it a few times, so it's not the best. So I thought this would be a really good addition to my my crafting corner. The next thing I bought were two fabrics which I'm going to use together for my Wildwood vest, which I have the pattern now cut out. It looks really, really great. I've read through the instructions. I've got myself primed and ready. And the outside is going to be navy cord. So this is kind of baby cord. And then the lining is going to be this pre-quilted fabric here. So you can just see on the back, it's got the batting wadding on the back and it's already been diamonded. So I think this would look very, very nice. However, the interfacing situation. So I bought interfacing a little while ago and brought it home, and I was trying to use it for a different project, and I was trying to iron it on and it did not iron on. I realized I bought like a meter of sew-in interfacing, which I've never used before. I meant to buy iron-on, which I always do. But then talking to the lovely Geraldine on Instagram, she was messaging me asking about interfacing and corduroy, and of course I had forgotten that I'm doing corduroy. Do I interface this? So now, do I use sew-in interfacing? Do I use iron-in interfacing? So I'm going to do a bit of a test and I'll let you guys know how I got on. So interesting, yes, and that hadn't even dawned on me, so thank you, Geraldine, for highlighting that. But that's going to be interesting, so we'll see how we go, because I think I should interface that. It's quite light cord, but it's lovely, and I think these colours match perfectly together. I did use a little bit of sew-in interfacing on the make that I've been working on, which I'll show you shortly, and that was my first foray into sew-in interfacing, and it didn't go too badly, but I wonder for a whole garment, would it be quite different? So that's my Wildwood vest, which I'm really excited about getting started on. Actually, I think that's going to be really fun. Then next up is the fabric for this new blouse, which I'm going to be making. And this is a lovely kind of a navy. It's almost like a seersuckery and it's got stars. And I'm going to call this my Sam shirt, because this just reminds me of the lovely Sam from So Let's Spark with Sam with stars in it. So I'm going to now call this my Sam shirt. So that was my lovely fabric haul. So I had a great time. I also bought a bit of elastic for my dress, which I'll show you shortly. So yeah, it was wonderful to have a pot around the fabric counter. They have fabulous stuff. I'll link them below. So they have a great online presence as well. So that's what I've been doing. I also went to the library, as I always do, and I thought I'd show you a few little books I picked up just for inspiration. So the first one is 3D Granny Squares, which is way beyond my crocheting level. If you see my Instagram, I am still doing my pumpkins. I'll pop in a little picture of them here. I've now got a ton of them done. I absolutely love them. I'm almost ready to start my wreath, but I thought this was really, really cool. And I just want to see what they look like. How gorgeous are they? So there's a couple that I was really drawn to. I think this little crab is really, really cute. And then the other one I thought was very cute was this little bee and a beehive. So I thought this was lovely to have a little look, a little bit of inspiration. The next thing I got was just, it's just called bags. So it does exactly what it says in the tin. So I love getting these just for inspiration as well. A few little ideas. And in this one, I was quite taken by this. So it's a little drawstring, I think, toiletry bag. Yes, drawstring toiletry bag. But then on the inside, it's all set into little segments that you can fit all your little bottles into, which I think is very cute. So I might look to give that a little try. I think that's a very cute pattern. The last one I got is Kath Kidston. So I think you probably got stuff with it originally, but not from the library. And the few little ones I liked on this one was, this one is called a sewing tidy, and it's a little flap over thing for your desk. You can put all your bibs and bobs there. I think that's very, very cute. So I put that under my dookie. And then the next thing is quite similar to the, oh, his name has gone from me. What's his name? The bag I just made recently from the guy who was on the sewing bee, and his name is completely gone from me. Stuart Hillard, that's it. So this is quite similar to his pattern in that it's got the little roll bag, and you've got all little segments for all your sewing bits, which I thought was very, very cute. So yeah, I really enjoy getting these books and getting a bit of inspiration from them. I think it's great. My local library has a fabulous selection of sewing books. So moving on, what else have I been up to? So thank you so much for all the feedback on my plans video. So I had asked about my dungarees, so I am definitely going to make those. I've now just the second bought fabric, and because I got tips on what to wear with them. You could wear long sleeve t-shirts, shirts, you could wear cardigans. So that was a great idea. So I'm now definitely going to get making those. So thank you for those recommendations. I also got a huge amount of recommendations for my joggers leggings debacle. So if you watch my plans video, I was debating between the Helen's Closet Avery, the Closetcore Plateau joggers, or the True Bias Hudson's. I didn't quite know what to do, and I got some really great feedback. So the main difference between the Closetcore Plateau and the True Bias Hudson pads apparently is to do with the rise. So I actually shortened the rise on my Plateau joggers because I thought they were very, very high, and I still think they are quite high. So I got some great feedback on various tutorials to tweak them and all that kind of stuff. But I got a lovely comment, and that recommended the Seamwork Mel jogger. So I'll pop in a picture here. They looked really, really great, and I thought they would be a really good idea as well. But when I was looking at those, it kind of recommended another pattern down below it, and they were the Seamwork Shelly leggings, which I really liked the look of. I'll pop in a picture here again. They looked really great. I've never made a seamwear pattern before. So I was kind of debating between those. And then I got another comment, and it was about the Love Notions Resolution Bottoms. So I had a quick look at them, promptly bought them. So thank you so much, because I think this is a really, really good pattern. Where did I put it? So these are the Resolution Bottoms. I'll pop up a picture here. So you can make joggers, you can make straight leg yoga pants, you can make boot cut yoga pants, and you can make plain and moto leggings. It's got a lovely curved waistband and a kind of curve yoke at the back as well. They look really, really great. So of course I promptly bought them. Love Notions had 40% off. And then also I follow Tomcat Stitchery on Instagram, and she has a 10% off code for Love Notions as well. So they ended up costing me about €6 win. So thank you so much for all your recommendations. I love putting things out into the universe here in this channel, and I get the most wonderful feedback. So thank you very, very much. So that's solved my legging problem. And I think I'm going to make those in a ponte, and I think I've spotted one which I shall buy shortly. So that was the feedback on my last video. Thank you very, very much. Oh, one more thing I did get feedback on. The Patty Do jumper that I wanted to make. I was told that they have a lovely YouTube channel and tutorials online as well, which is great. I didn't realise that. So thank you very, very much for that. So that was everything I want to show you there. What have I been working on? So I've been working on my Sienna dress, and this is where the sewing interfacing came in. So I've made pretty good progress. I cut this out in the beautiful border print fabric. So I think I've done pretty well. So here's the skirt and you can see the border at the bottom. So not bad going here. I cut the back on the fold because there's no reason to cut in two pieces. So I've learnt my lesson from the last time. And then I'm pretty much finished the bodice. So here's the bodice, the lovely collar. That's where the sewing interfacing is, and it didn't go in too badly. I did a little button and a little thread loop at the back, and I thought because of the month we're in, I put a little trick or treat label in the back, which I think is really cute. Not that it's in any way a Halloween dress, but the label is cute. And then all I have to do is do the sleeves. So I did the border on the sleeves as well. I need to just turn them up and put in elastic because I like rolling up my sleeves. And then here's the end with the lovely border as well. And this just needs to be attached to the skirt and the elastic put in, and I'm pretty much done. I pretty much did this without the instructions this time just because it was so straightforward and I loved it the last time. One other thing it doesn't tell you to do on the pattern is to do gathering stitches on the sleeve, which I think you really, really need to do before you insert it, because there's no way you're going to ease them in. So gathering stitches on the sleeves. I cut the back skirt on the fold, and yes, I just altered the cuffs, and I did top stitch down the bottom here, which it also doesn't tell you to do. So they're my little tweaks, but I love this pattern. You'll be seeing an awful lot more of these, and I'll pop in a picture of me wearing my other Sienna dress as well, because I got a better picture of that one. So that's what I've been working on. What am I going to work on next week? So I'm going to do that little bag that I mentioned that I was being very coy about. So I'll cut out my wildwood now that I have my fabric. I've got that pattern cut out, and I'm also going to get going on the Roscoe sweater because I have that lovely white fabric as well. So I've got plenty of things now to keep me occupied during the week. Oh, and finishing off my pumpkin wreath as well. So that's about it on the sewing front. Now to catch up a bit on the life. So we've had a busy week. Older French Seams was a bit poorly last weekend. He ended up with an ear infection. Then younger French Seams had high temperatures during the week. So he was at home when we were working from home as well. We were looking after him. But as of now, they're both absolutely fine. But it's very much back to school bugs. It really, really is. But no, they're both doing great at the minute, which is wonderful. They're both looking forward to Halloween. I did get asked, am I going to be making their costumes this year? No. Younger French Seams has a ready-to-wear dinosaur costume. He's happy out with that. Older French Seams is determined to squeeze into the dinosaur costume I made him last year. So I'll pop in a picture here, which suits me fine, and I'll make the new costumes next year. I'm thinking about my costume though, so I think I might be able to kind of repurpose a few things. I have my wardrobe to make a little costume for me, which is kind of fun. I did have a very, very exciting weekend last weekend though, because I got to meet a few lovely, lovely sewing people. So the lovely Laurie Ann, who I'm sure you all know and love, that you've seen on various people's channels, she was over in Ireland, and she stopped by Dublin, and I met her off her cruise ship, which was very exciting, and I got to meet the lovely Larry as well briefly, and then I just spent the day with Laurie Ann and showing her around Dublin, and we met up with the lovely Agatha, whose channel here is in Agatha's Cottage. I'll link it down below. And then I also got to meet the lovely Amanda again. So Amanda I did meet in the Beyond the Pink Door sewing retreat back in May, but it was really great to meet her again. So we all converged in Dublin and we had the most wonderful day. We saw the sights. I'll pop in pictures here. We did Trinity, we had a look at Dublin Castle, we looked at St. Patrick's Cathedral, we did all bits and pieces like this, and it was just the most wonderful, wonderful day. We had a gorgeous lunch and the sun shone all day. It was marvellous. It was just such a lovely, lovely way to spend a day, and just honoured that Laurie Ann stopped off in Dublin, and we just got to spend the most wonderful day. We just did not stop talking about sewing all day. It was just magic. It really, really was. So wonderful to see you, Laurie Ann. You are always welcome, and safe home and safe onward travels. And hello to the two ladies again, and we need to do another meetup either in Dublin or somewhere else very, very soon, because it was just the best day. Sewing people are the best people. So that about rounds it up. So that was my life for the week. So next week is going to be busy again, but as I mentioned, I've got a few little plans I'd like to do. So watch this space. I hope to come back to you now next week with another Friday Sews. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and I would love it if you would consider subscribing. If you'd like to leave me a comment below, I would love that. You know how much I love having the chats. Let me know if you've done any of these projects, or if you've any comments on any of my other projects. I'd love to hear about them. And I think I will leave it there for now. I hope you're all well, and I will see you all again very, very soon. Take care, everyone. Bye.